New video! Okay, so as you'll see is the title, and seeing this, I guess probably the picture it might show when I upload it, is this is another rehearsal that I like. This one kind of shows the sounds that I was talking about that Elvis may make in his and his songs when he records them for the actual album release, and he also mentions that in this one. So let's watch this one. Can I just say, because of this clip that I watch it a lot, he always has me saying I was the one that taught her to lie now, and it's his fault because he does this trying to be funny. And you know the way she touches your cheek. I taught her how.
See what this is? What this is, Dennis, is these are some of the, like, the first songs I did, you know, long before World War II.
That's so true.
Yeah, the olden days. So I like to play a few of those.
They laugh and say, oh, the olden days, but it's true. He did these songs before World War II when he was in the Army.
He's only 426. So, before World War II, that's all. You know, I was just a baby.
Just a baby.
I was the one who taught her to.
That's the noise he makes.
I used to do all the background stuff too, you know.
See?
All the background.
I told you. He does a couple in this one.
Here we go. That's it. That's where they ended. Just nothing. Nothing. I was the one. Just kind of faded off. Everybody's standing around going, what happened? What happened?
Oh, goodness. He could be, like, I say this all the time, he could be a comedian if you wanted to. And other people say it, but I've been saying it for a while now, especially when I first started researching him. He could be a comedian on the side along with his career of music, and he would just be even bigger than what he was, because people say they had to, like Priscilla, oh, they had to laugh at his jokes. No, they didn't have to laugh, but me just watching him personally, he was funny as hell anyway, so I don't see why you have to laugh. But whatever, you know, some people say certain things, we don't know. I love this man.
And also my last one, too.
I mean, if you cannot watch him and not smile like James, and right now, as I pause it, James is smiling in the red shirt. That's all he did was grin and smile watching Elvis. If you can't do that, then I honestly don't think that you can truly love this man and be a fan, because watching him and just looking at him and being around him, I hear that he would walk into a room and people could feel his presence. He just had this presence about him that drew you in. And, like, it made you love him. And like I said, James would smile all the time. And I really understand why he did it, because that's all I do watching this man. He was lovable in and uncontrollably funny. There's no way you cannot watch this man and learn about him and love him. You just can't.
You may go to college, may go to school. You may get religion, baby, don't you be nobody's fool. Now, baby, come back, baby.
He's got me trying to figure out how he does it, because when he says, baby, 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 it's really, it's amazing how his voice can change like that. He's literally making different sounds that instruments will make. And if you pay attention close enough, you'll know what I'm talking about. So I every day when I listen to this one, I try to figure out how he does it, and I try to do it myself. Not gonna lie, I really do. Okay, guys, I hope you enjoyed that video, but another thing that I wanted to mention is, some of you guys who have been following me know this is my collection that I started down here, and I'll take it off. This is a postcard that I got, if you can see it, I know the lighting's bad. But it's a postcard that I got that has signatures from Billy and Joe and his two sons, their wives, and their grandson, Dakota. Now, they sent me a postcard after Christmas time, not knowing who I was. Isn't that funny? And they all autographed it. So people who might see these pictures, like, in the background, excuse me, I can get it hung up. Ugh. It actually, the frame broke when I tried to put it back up on my other video. But they are from Billy and Joe and his son Will and all them and their grandson Dakota. They all autographed a postcard and sent it to me after Christmas. So I was very thankful for that. They have no idea who I am. I haven't even told them yet. They know I follow their page. And they know I spent $25 on Christmas cards to send them to them for their t-shirt contest. Their t-shirt contest, which I never found out. What happened with that? They haven't done a video on the contest yet, so I don't know who won. I just know I paid $25 to send them Christmas cards, and I told them about it. I said it cost me $25 because it's Christmas time, and I had to overnight it. So they sent me a postcard and autographed it. So when you see these pictures, like this one in the background, there's some pictures that I ordered and paid for to start my collection with Elvis, along with this necklace that some people who have been following my page for a while know. I paid for some pictures without printing them all for free. I was stupid. And I bought this scarf for like $12. Normally it's $50 online. And then under it is the postcard that Billy Smith and Joe Smith, his wife, and his two sons and their grandson, they all autographed it and sent me. So that's what that is, and I wanted to mention that. So I hope you guys really enjoyed the video. Have a great night, everybody.